evildoer. It's jail for you, you tasty villain! You and your chocolate chip gang are through! Boy, eating cookies is hard work. But there's only one more box to go, and I'll have 20 box tops. And that means I can get the Pajama Man action figure with Titanic elbow thrust. I can hardly wait.
Sam! It's almost time for dinner.
Dinner? Oh boy, I don't feel so good. Uh-oh, I don't think that was me. Spoil my dinner, and now they've gone to cause trouble somewhere else. Somebody's gotta stop them. Somebody like Pajama Sam. Of course, I'll need my cape. I like this music. Those cookies left a trail of crumbs. As soon as I find my cape, I can follow them. Aha! All right, cookies. Your dinner spoiling days are over. Pajama Sam is on his way. Those cookies left a trail of crumbs. Those cookies shouldn't be hard to find. The pantry, of course. Hello? Is somebody there?
Nobody here but us potatoes.
All right, cookies. I know you're in here. What? Hey, that tickled. Where are you taking me? What? Whoa!
Pajama Sam! It's a night thing. Call him Pajama Sam!
Whoa! Oh boy! A party! Oh boy, a box top! If I can find 20 of these, I can get a Pajama Man action figure with Titanic elbow thrust!
Yep.
Salt, fat, chocolate, and the sweet truth. It's time.
Wow. Is this party for me? I think you spelled my name wrong.
How's that?
On the sign, Sam should only have one S.
Oh, that? Oh, that's S-S-A-M. It stands for Snacks and Sweets Aggressive Majority.
Oh. I'm Sam.
Of course, otherwise he wouldn't be here, right?
Oh, I can't believe I ate the whole thing.
You ate it, Sam.
Well, thanks everyone. This is a great party, but I think I should be going now. It's almost my dinner time and I wouldn't want to spoil it. My mom made all that broccoli?
You can just wait here in jail until your trial next month, healthy boy.
Next month? But it's almost time for dinner.
Tell it to the fudge. Now if you'll excuse me, I've got to get back to the party. Tra-la-la-la-la.
I can't stay in here a whole month. I've got to get out of here. All right, a box top. My name's Sam.
I'm Florette. Are you a political prisoner too?
I don't know. I think I'm in here because I said I didn't want to spoil my dinner.
Hmm. The sweets don't always get along well with the other foods.
But I'm not a food. How come you're in here, Florette? Did you not want to spoil your dinner too?
I'm one of the delegates to the big peace conference at the Food Pyramid.
Peace conference?
Yes. Delegates from all the food groups are supposed to get together to work out our differences. I represent the vegetables.
Oh. Florette, I don't see what you being a... What did you call it?
Peace delegate?
Right. What does that have to do with you being in jail?
Those sweets locked me up in here because they don't want the peace conference to happen.
I had no idea that sweets were so mean.
They're not all like that. It's mostly just this one group. Sometimes, when you get a lot of them together, they get a little crazy.
That's funny. My mom says the same thing about my big brother and his friends. We've really gotta get out of here. You need to get to your peace conference, and I've gotta be home in time for dinner.
How are we going to get out?
Never fear! Pajama Sam is here! I'll get us out of here! That key will open the cell door. It's too bad I can't reach the key. Boy, that's quite a lock. Hey, bonbons! I like those. Yes! My arms aren't long enough. Hey, I think this is... Oops. Gee, I didn't mean to break anything. Well, maybe this will come in handy. Maybe I deserve a reward.
Before they come back.
Okay, let's go.
Sweet troops. We'd better not let them see us. I've got to get to that peace conference at the food pyramid as quickly as possible. Thank you so much for getting us out of there, Sam. You're a real hero. See you later.
Gee. Those troops shouldn't bother me. After all, there's no blue food, right? But I'm not taking any chances. I'm not going over there with all those soldiers around. I can't go back to jail. I've got more important stuff to do. I've got to get home for dinner. Wow! What a neat building. Another box top!
Am I glad to see you? The island of Moptop is in big trouble.
Moptop?
Yeah, Moptop. Here's what's going down. The folks who live on Moptop are all foods, right? The Fats and Sweets group is taking over. There's just so many of them. They're causing problems all over the island. General Beetfoot wants to declare war on them.
That doesn't sound very good.
You got that right. So, I've organized a peace conference. One member of each of the six food groups has been chosen as a delegate, and they're supposed to all get together here at the pyramid to talk out their differences.
I think Florette said something about that before.
Right. She's one of the delegates at the conference. Trouble is, only two are here, and there are supposed to be six. That's bad news. We need everybody, or the conference is off.
What? The conference is off? All right, that's it. This means war!
No, General, no! The conference is still on.
Hi, I'm Pajama Sam.
Great rhubarb, Private! It's about time you got here! Where are those reports I asked for?
I'm sorry, I don't think you asked me for any reports. We've never really spoken before.
Oh? Well then, it's a good thing you didn't bring me any reports. Keep it up, lad. You might get a promotion out of this.
Oh, one more thing, Sam. I've got to stay here and keep the general from declaring war. So somebody needs to find the other four delegates and get them here. They must have run into trouble, or they'd be here by now.
I can find them for you. Pajama Sam always helps those in need. But how will I recognize them?
That part is easy. They'll all be wearing straw hats. Florette and Luke Wigglebig are here. The delegates still missing are Chuck Cheddar, Bean 47, Granny Smythe, and Pierre Lapin.
What's this? A garrison of sweets just marched through the headlands! War, I tell you!
No, General, wait!
Boy, I better find those delegates and get them here as fast as I can! Hi, Florette. I guess this must be the peace conference, right?
Yes, that's right. It's nice to see you again, Sam.
Ah, gee. I'm glad to see you made it here okay.
All thanks to you, Sam.
Excuse me, I don't believe we've met.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. Luke, this is Pajama Sam. Sam, this is Luke Wigglebig from the Fast and Sweet.
I was asked to be here because of my remarkably good taste.
I see.
When are we going to start this conference anyway?
When everyone has arrived.
Ah, another box top! Hi, I'm Sam. You're the librarian, right?
Yes, that's right.
Why are you crying? Can I help?
Oh, no, thank you. It's this book I'm reading. It's very sad.
What book are you reading? Is it one of the classics?
Oh, well, sort of. You see, it's a... Oh, right, it's not one of the classics. It's called Passion in Pittsburgh. I got it at the supermarket. Satisfied?
Sure, there's nothing wrong with that.
You really think so?
Sure.
Well, don't tell anybody just the same. We librarians have to keep up appearances.
Okay. My lips are sealed.
Thank you.
What are these?
Those are library cards. If you could bring me a picture of yourself, I'll put it on the card and you'll be able to borrow books from the library.
Neat. Selena Celery Garnich. Good for one free dance lesson. Oh boy, I like dancing. Another box top! That water looks kind of cold to go swimming. That water looks kind of cold to go swimming. What a cool looking tree! I think there's ketchup growing on it. And some other stuff too. I don't think I can get over there. It looks like it's too far for me to swim. A big donut! And it's a swing! Whee!
Hi, I'm Sprinkle.
Hi, I'm Sam. I'm sorry, I didn't realize you were... I mean, I should have asked.
That's okay, I love to swing. What else would I be doing tied to a tree like this?
That's a good point. What else do you like to do besides swing, Sprinkle?
I used to like to swim quite a bit. Well, float, really. I'm a good floater. Whoop! Oh my! It's a good thing I can float. Say, the water is very nice today.
Another box top. Hi, how are you today?
Oh, we're good.
We're guards.
Yeah, we're guarding it. Entrance.
This entrance right here. We're guarding it.
I see. Can I go inside?
Well, let's see.
It's no guards allowed.
No, that's not right. It's guards only.
Guards only, that's right. And, he's not a guard, so...
So that would mean...
And that would mean, no, you can't go in. No admittance.
Unless you're a guard.
Which you're not.
A guard.
Sorry.
That's okay. Another box top! Hi! I'm Pajama Sam!
Shh! This is an avalanche zone! If you make too much noise, tons of snow could come sliding down the mountain.
Oh... You guys sure are working hard!
Shh, quiet! Remember what we said about the avalanches.
Oh yeah? How come you're doing all this digging?
Because we're good at it.
Hello!
Howdy!
You're wearing a straw hat. Are you one of the delegates to the peace conference?
I sure am. I'm Chuck Cheddar, Cheese of Adventure!
I'm Pajama Sam! Do you need help?
I think so. I parachuted in and got stuck on this ledge. Now I can't get across.
I'll see what I can do.
Much obliged, Pajama Sam. You know, I once jumped a motorcycle across the Grand Canyon. You'd think a hole this size wouldn't be that much of a problem.
Don't worry, Mr. Cheddar. I'll find a way to get you across. Do you think you could make a bridge so that poor guy over there could get across?
We don't build stuff. We only dig.
Why are you guys so worried about avalanches?
Last time there was an avalanche, it filled up the hole we were digging. We had to start all over again.
That poor guy over there is stuck. Maybe if you filled in the hole, he could get across.
Fill in the hole? Ha!
No way.
Yeah, we only dig holes. We don't fill them. If that guy's stuck, it's his problem.
How long are you gonna be digging today?
Oh, all day, I expect. We like digging.
Why? Avalanche zone.
Avalanche means that if you make a loud enough noise, a bunch of snow might come falling down the mountain.
I see. Here's another box top. I'm Sam.
I am called Syllabus the Sage. For reasons I cannot fathom.
Fathom?
I sit here atop Mount Wisdom and ponder the deeper mysteries of the universe.
What are you pondering right now?
I am considering the nature of cheese.
Ooh, I like cheese.
Well then, perhaps you will be able to help me find the answer to the great three-part question of the nature of cheese.
What are the three parts of the question?
First, I must know which fork at the table is the cheese fork.
I don't know that one.
The second part of the question is this. What sort of cheese is the moon made of?
The moon is made of cheese?
The last part is perhaps the most important. What sort of cheese is the best to put in a cheese sandwich?
That That's a good one. I'll let you know if I can find out the answers to any of those.
Thank you, young man.
Hey, a gondola! I wonder where it goes. A ski resort! Boy, this place has got everything! Here's another box top! Skis and poles are self-service. Look at all those different routes! Oh boy, I'm gonna go skiing! Last one to the bottom is a rotten egg!
You come in for a swim, Sam. The water's lovely.
I don't want to get too wet before dinner, but maybe you could give me a ride.
Sure, hop on.
A box top. Wow, what a log jam! And it's all French fries. Hello?
Hello, French Fry.
I'm not a French Fry. I'm Pajama Sam.
Oh, so you are.
Pity. Do you like French fries?
I love French fries. Especially with ketchup. Ketchup. That's the only way I'll eat them, actually, is with ketchup on them. Then there's no stopping me.
Hey, I like them with ketchup, too.
Ha! You're a young man of good taste.
Boy, this is great! Look at all these different sauces!
Yes, it's a condiment tree!
Mustard! I like mustard on my sandwiches! Ew, horseradish! This stuff is too strong for me. But some people like it. I'll take this horseradish anyway. It might come in handy. This is mayonnaise. Mom puts it in deviled eggs. Yum! Hot sauce! And it's the extra spicy kind. This is teriyaki sauce. My mom likes to cook things with it. I might find a use for this teriyaki sauce. I better take it. I'll put this other one back. I don't want to be greedy. I'll take this mayonnaise. It could come in handy. I'll just put this back for now. This barbecue sauce. I put this on my peas. Mom thinks I'm nuts, but it's good. I better take this barbecue sauce, just in case. I'll just put this back for now. This one's vinegar. It tastes awful by itself, but it's good on salads and things. This is relish, the kind you make with pickles. You never know when you might need some relish. I'll just put this back for now. Mustard. I'll just put this back for now.
like mustard on my sandwiches.
This mustard might be useful. Boy, ketchup. Ketchup is good on everything. This ketchup might come in handy. I'll just put this back for now.
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy!
Well, so much for not getting wet.
I thought that was fun.
Look at that big red squishy thing.
In here.
It sure is. Let's not stick around too long.
Okay. Here's another box top. Welcome to the Blubbers. Elma Celery. Garnish. Good for one free etiquette lesson. Well, it's free.
Ooh, etiquette lessons.
What is etiquette anyway?
It's like being polite when you talk. Setting the table properly. That kind of stuff.
Oh. What are you all jumping for?
It's not jumping, we're dancing. It's called the pogo.
Hello, I'm Pajama Sam. Are you one of the delegates to the peace conference?
That's right. I'm Granny Smythe. That's Smythe. With a Y, mind you. Get it right.
Yes, ma'am.
And there's one more thing I want to say.
What's that?
Help!
I don't think I can get to you. Can you get out?
No, I can't get my footing at all. Too much bouncing around going on. You've got to put a stop to it.
I'll see what I can do. Do you think you could stop dancing so that lady could get out?
Stop dancing? No way, we gotta dance. Don't mess with our freedom of expression.
Oh, good! Another box top! I'm Sam. You guys are all plumbers, right?
Right!
How come you don't have a plunger like the other guys do?
I lost it the other day while I was skiing. It doesn't matter too much, since I mostly just handle the paperwork anyway.
Is that a Pajama Man lunchbox?
No, this is the RX-1000 food suspender, the Cadillac of lunchboxes. It's vacuum sealed, and it has a nitrogen-based temperature regulator.
That's pretty fancy for a lunchbox.
No, it has to be. Inside, perfectly preserved, I've got the ultimate. The best cheese sandwich ever made.
Really? I love cheese sandwiches. What kind of cheese do you use?
Munster, of course. It's the best for cheese sandwiches.
Sounds delicious. Shall we?
Let's shall.
Welcome to Muscle Beach. Zach's closed for the season. Another box top! Hi, I'm Pajama Sam. Are you one of the delegates for the peace conference?
But yes, I am Pierre Lepin of the Breads and Grains group.
Can you get down from there?
Alas, no, I am trapped. The Ferris wheel, she has no power. The exercise machine on the beach furnishes the power, but no one seems to be exercising, and so she does not move.
Well, I'll think of something.
Thank you. For the peace conference to be deprived of Pierre? This is not good. Do you know if the conference it has started already?
I think they're waiting for everyone to get there first.
Ah, this is good.
But if everyone doesn't get there soon, the general is going to declare war on the sweets and fats.
Ah, this. It is not so good. You must get me down so that I may help.
I'll think of something. Pierre, what were you doing on a Ferris wheel anyway? I thought you were supposed to be on your way to the conference.
Ah, well, you see, I was distracted by a young lady. Eclair, she was called, and she was most sweet.
Did she take you on the Ferris wheel?
She was in need of the attentions of Pierre. I could not refuse.
His machine is connected to the Ferris wheel.
Yep, that's right, little dude. When we work out, it makes the wheel go around.
Boy, you guys look healthy.
Yeah.
We know.
Shouldn't you be working out or something?
Not now, dude.
We're busy.
We have to draw those cupcakes for our art class.
Do you guys like to work out?
Oh, yeah.
Working out is almost as important to us as our drawing assignment.
But not quite.
We've got to draw those cupcakes so we can be famous artists someday.
I see. Hi, what's up?
Oh, you know, we're just baking, you know.
How will you know when you're done baking?
Like we use a timer, you know.
PTH will be totally over when the bell rings.
What does PTH mean again?
Hello? Peak tanning hours?
I'm so sure.
Those muffins over there are drawing us? They said they're taking an art class or something.
Like, whatever.
It's all right with us, as long as they don't block our rays.
Get it this way.
Please pose for your picture. You're allowed one photo per customer.
Ew, do I really look like that? Hi, you sell balloons?
Give the boy a college scholarship, he's a genius.
Do you like selling balloons?
Oh yeah. Get the fulfillment of all my hopes and dreams.
Hey, those are nice! Oops.
Darn these laces, they're always coming undone. Here, kid, hold these for me, would you?
I'd be happy to. Whoops.
We're done, girls. Peak tanning hours are over.
Bye-bye, boys. Let's go get some frozen yogurt.
Aww.
Darn. I hope they come back tomorrow.
What'll we do until then?
Work out some more.
What else?
Yeah!
All right.
The wheel, it turns.
I am severed!
Help?
Courage, mon ami! You must grab onto the wheel! Ah, excellent! Now we are both severed, and I can continue on to the Conference of Peace.
Say, what happened to my... Oh, shoot. Oh, well, I needed a new career anyhow.
Perhaps you can start the taxi service. I need to go to the food pyramid. Can you take me there?
Sure, hop in.
Au revoir, my pajama friend.
Au revoir! Well, that's one down, three to go.
Ha! But seriously, folks, let me ask you this. What goes ha 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 ha, plop plop plop? An orange holding its breath.
Hey! You ain't funny!
Bring back the other guy!
Don't you get it? Orange, breath, plop plop plop.
Plop this, wise guy!
It's true. He really isn't very funny.
But hey, tell me, what do you think of these shoes, eh? Thank you, thank you. All right. Next up is Tom Rutabaga, the Knock Knock King.
Mickey Hollandaise, folks! Mickey Hollandaise in his great big floppy shoes! Alright, folks, check this out! It'll knock you right out of your seat! Knock, knock!
Who's there?
Omelette!
Omelette who?
I'm a lot funnier than Mickey Hollandaise is! Try this one! Knock, knock!
Who's there?
Hair!
Hair who?
Apparently you don't want to open the door! But I wish you would!
Hi! I saw your act.
Tell me the truth. Did I stink?
Well...
I knew it. Oh, I am awful!
No, I wouldn't say that.
I haven't been able to tell a decent joke since... Well, since those sweet troopers marched through here and got my note cards all out of order. I'm a lousy comedian.
How did you say your note cards got messed up again?
It was the sweet troops marching through here. I think they did it on purpose. No senses of humor on those guys.
How big are these shoes anyway?
They're size 37. I got them cheap from a big hairy guy in California who said he didn't like the colors. I'm such a failure. Did I tell you once I bombed so badly that the audience followed me home and threw vegetables at my house?
That is bad. Hey, why did the chicken cross the road?
Because I can't remember. Oh no!
Don't worry, it's okay.
My career is over.
Who's that other guy who's telling jokes out there now?
Tom Rutabaga. What a hack he is. I don't know how he gets laughs with those old tired jokes. I guess they make sense at least.
Let me take a look at your note cards. Maybe I can help put them back in order.
Be my guest.
An orange holding its breath. I think that one's funny. This might sound better. A strawberry driving a car. That might work. I think that one's funny. I think that one's funny. There. Why don't you try them now?
Hey, I think you're right. I think this is better. I'm going to try them. I'm going to try them without the shoes.
Ooh, hey, check it out. I've got another one for you.
Who's there?
It's me, Mickey Hollandaise, top banana for all your comedy needs. May I have the spotlight, please? Hey! Now this joke was a favorite of my close personal friend, Elvis Presley. What's round and tangy and blue? An orange holding its breath! Elvis used to ask me, what's small and red and goes 60 miles an hour? Anyone? Huh? It's a strawberry driving a car! Oh yeah, and here's one of the deeper mysteries. What can you use to make a salad, build a boat, and brush your teeth? Lettuce, wood, and a toothbrush. You, ma'am, there in the front row. Tell me, what has yellow and green stripes, 600 legs, and great big fangs?
Why, I don't know.
I don't know either, but it's crawling on your shoulder. Just kidding, ma'am. No harm done, I hope. Now, does anyone know what goes ha 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 ha, plop plop plop? An audience laughing their heads off!
Boy, that went really well.
It was my finest performance, and I owe it all to you. Thank you for helping me put my jokes and my career back together.
You're welcome.
And as for you, you great unwieldy galoshes, I shall need you no more. Now, if you'll excuse me, young man, I've got to go and have a little talk with my agent.
Daddy doesn't need these anymore, so I guess it's okay if I take them. This pumpkin's hardly been used. It seems like a shame to throw it out.
You like that, huh? Okay, how about this one? Knock, knock!
Who's there?
Wheat!
Wheat who?
We'd like you to open the door so we can come in!
I could use a ride again.
Hop on!
The foothills. Oh, good, another box stop. Another box stop. Garnish.
That would be garnish, dear boy. Do try it.
Garnish.
Excellently done.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome. Hello, young man. How may we help you?
My name is Sam.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Sam. My name is Selma Celery, and this is my sister, Selena Celery. Hello.
Hello.
We teach dancing and etiquette here. What do you do?
Right now, I'm helping a carrot prevent a war by finding peace delegates and getting them to a big conference.
How delightful.
Yes, war is always such a filthy business.
Excuse me. I thought you might like to have these shoes.
Oh, my. They're wonderful. Why, I've never seen such colorful shoes before. And they fit. They fit perfectly. They're so comfortable. I can dance again. Oh, thank you, young man. Thank you.
You're welcome. Excuse me.
Yes?
I have a coupon for a free etiquette lesson.
So you do, young man, so you do. Come right in. Table manners are the most commonly neglected rules of etiquette in these modern times, so that's what we'll cover in today's lesson. First, a few pointers, all right?
Okay.
Never rest your arm on the table while eating. Eat your soup with a spoon. Do not slurp it from the bowl. Never throw food at the table. Excuse yourself before making funny animal noises. Do not draw and poke holes in or set fire to the tablecloth. Standing on the table during a meal is not permitted. Eat all the food on your plate and do it in alphabetical order. Are we okay so far?
I guess so.
Good. Now a few words about place settings. The dinner plate goes in the center with the bread plate to the left and the glass or glasses at the upper right. Silverware should be placed as follows. Forks on the left. Salad fork. Seafood fork. And steak fork. To the right we have the steak knife. Seafood knife. Soup spoon. Cocktail weenie poker. Swizzle stick. And mashy niblick. Dessert silverware is set separately after the meal. Any questions?
Which one is the cheese fork?
The cheese fork will be the one which is brought with the cheese.
Oh, that's easy then.
This concludes our lesson for today. Thank you for coming, and we do hope you'll consider us for all your etiquette needs in the future.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I have a coupon for a free dance lesson.
Terrific! Right this way! Waltzing is really quite easy once you get the hang of it. And one, two, three, one, two, three. Yes, you're doing very well.
This is fun!
Well, I think that's about all the time we have.
I'm a dancing fool!
Thank you. Do come again.
A box top. I think this makes 20.
I'm the foreman here at the factory. You're not looking for work, are you?
No.
Good. I've got enough troubles as it is. I'm supposed to sort everybody out with this new BCS 4000 bean counter sorter machine, but I don't even have a manual to tell me how to put it together. Oh dear, oh dear.
have a really great mustache.
Thank you. As foreman, I'm allowed to wear a mustache.
Did it take long to grow?
Oh no, it's a false one. We beans can't actually grow hair.
I see. I see you've got a straw hat. Are you a delegate to the peace conference?
No, I'm the foreman here. I was supposed to give this hat to Bean number 47, who is our delegate. But I can't.
Why not?
Because we don't know which bean is number 47. I was going to use the new BCS 4000 bean counter sorter. But I don't have the instruction manual, so I can't put it together.
That does sound like a problem.
It is. Oh dear. Oh dear.
BCS 4000. Boy, there are a lot of parts in there.
It's a hopeless mess, and the instruction manual didn't come with it, so I've got no way at all of putting it together.
Hey, couldn't you just ask the beans which one of them is number 47?
No, I'm afraid they don't know either. It's never been very important to be able to tell us apart, until now.
What if we just lined all the beans up and gave them numbers by hand?
Oh, that would take forever, and we couldn't be sure of getting it right. Nope, we're going to have to use the BCS 4000 machine.
If the beans are so much alike, why don't we just pick one and give that one the hat?
Oh no, that wouldn't be right. It has to be number 47. That's already been decided.
Okay, let me get this straight. Bean number 47 needs to go to the peace conference.
Yes.
But we can't find bean number 47 until we get this bean counting machine put together.
Yes.
And we can't do that until we get a hold of the manual.
Oh, yes.
So the first thing is we need the manual.
Exactly.
Where are we supposed to find that?
I have no idea. Oh, dear.
I'd really like to find the instructions to put this together. There must be somewhere I could find a book like that. Shall we? Let's shall. I need any more sauces right now. Look, a sweet potato.
Where is that?
I don't see anybody.
Oh, hello, sir.
Welcome to the A complex, Mr.
Gord. Sam Gord.
Mr. Gord, very good.
Oh yes, that's very good.
I think I'll just go on in here now.
Hold it, that's the... Oh, wait a minute. It's Gord's only, right?
Yes, and he's a Gord. So I guess that means,
That means we let him in.
Aha!
This is more cramped than the hall closet of our house. I bet I could see all the way around the world with this thing. 100% mild cheddar. The moon is made of cheddar cheese!
Neat. Look, a balloon.
Where?
Are you sure?
The three parts of the great question of the nature of cheese again?
Part one is which fork at the table is the cheese fork?
Oh, I found that one out. The cheese fork is the one that gets brought with the cheese.
Excellent. It is elegant in its simplicity. Well then, let us move on. Part two is what type of cheese is the moon made of?
Oh, sure. I remember now. I saw it through the telescope. It's cheddar.
Amazing. A telescope. Why didn't I think of that? Part three is, what sort of cheese is the best to put in a cheese sandwich?
Oh, I know which one it is. The plumber told me Munster cheese is the best.
Of course. Plumbers are renowned for their excellent taste in cheese sandwiches. Well, this is fabulous. You've helped me to answer all the parts of the great question of the nature of cheese. You are a wise young man, Sam.
Thank you.
And now, for my favorite part.
We get to eat some cheese?
No, we get to blow the horn of celebration. I do it every time I get the answer to one of my questions. Since you helped me so much, perhaps you would like to do the honors.
Oh boy, would I?
Oh no! Not again!
Wow!
Say, kid, great plan. You really helped me out of a jam here. Thanks.
You're welcome.
I'd stick around and swap stories with you, but I've got to get to that peace conference pronto. See you around, Sam.
Bye!
Well, I guess we gotta start the hole over again.
Let's take a break first.
Good idea. Come on, everybody. Break time.
Well, that's two delegates down, two to go.
Good help nowadays.
Hey, Sam, have you rescued any delegates lately?
As a matter of fact, yes. I've helped two of them. There are only two more to go.
Capital, baby, capital.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Ah, there you are, Private. What's the news from the front?
The front? It looks like pajamas, same as always.
Ha ha! Very good. Now off with you, young man. There's a war on, isn't there?
I think the general is about ready to explode. How's it coming with the delegates?
I still have to rescue two of them, but I'm working on it.
Private! Why aren't you guarding the telescope at A Complex?
I'm sorry. I think you've got me confused with someone else.
Me? How do you know it's not you that's got you confused? I'm never confused about anything! Except for that one time at the trifle range. But that hardly counts! Man the torpedoes!
Yes, sir. Pardon me?
Why, did you do something wrong? Well, no time for that now! Big things are afoot!
I might need another one of these dance lesson coupons. Here's a photo of me.
Now I can make you a library card.
Suppose I wanted to find instructions for putting together a BCS 4000 bean counting and sorting machine. Where would I look?
Ah, you want the BCS 4000 Operator's Guide by Dr. Gizmo Flutewing. Go through there to the stacks, then look in the technical section. Second shelf, all the way to the right. It's a great big blue book. You can't miss it.
Thanks. There's the bean sorter manual. It's on the second shelf. I can click on those elevators to go up and down. Can I use this card now?
Yes, you can. You may keep the book for 3 weeks. After that, the fine is $400 a day.
That seems like kind of a lot.
Just have the book back in 3 weeks!
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Another ride.
Sure, anytime.
For a free dance lesson?
Free? Great! Hey, there's a phone number at the bottom. I'll give him a call right now. Hello, I'm calling about free dance lessons. Oh, great! Well, there's a lot of us. It might be better if you came here. Stand back? What are you... Yeah!
Hello!
Wow! Great trick!
Yeah! My, we do have work to do. All right, listen up, everyone. Grab a partner. We're going to learn to waltz. Now watch out. Do as we do. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Good.
Watch it. Watch it.
Old lady coming through. Good heavens! I thought I was never going to get out of there! Young people have no respect these days. Except for you, of course, young man. You really helped me by getting them to stop that horrible jumping.
Pajama Sam always helps those in need.
Well, that's good. I'd love to stay and dance, but I've got to be off now. They'll need me at the peace conference. Goodbye and thank you.
Bye. That's three down. Only one more to go. They look like they're having fun. That Miss Celery is a good teacher. Hey, Sprinkle, how about another ride?
Sure, anytime.
About technical manuals?
Oh!
It's the BCS 4000 Operator's Guide by Dr. Gizmo Flutewing. Sprouts be praised! We can put the machine together!
Quick, help me. Take an end.
That ought to just about do it.
Thanks for all your help, Sam. Hey, what do you say? Shall we fire it up? I'll let you do the honors.
Sure!
All beans to the counting and sorting machine.
I can use this machine to sort the beans and find number 47. The kidney beans go on one side, and the jelly beans go on the other.
Thank you.
win! Yahoo!
Well, it looks like you're bean number 47. So you've got to represent us at the peace conference.
It's a great honor!
You better take this hat, in case there's any confusion.
Thank you, Foreman! I'll be on my way immediately!
I'd better get to the food pyramid myself to make sure everything goes okay.
Good work, Sam. And good luck.
Thanks.
I'm telling you, meals should consist strictly of dairy products, for health reasons.
But it is the breads which are the most healthy of foods.
Hi, everybody. How's it going?
Krusty here thinks he's healthier than I am.
This cheese has gone rancid. I cannot negotiate with him.
Uh-oh.
You're bull fools. The bean way is the only way.
Nonsense! Fruits are the principal staple for meals and dessert.
What do you know, you old crabapple?
A lot more than you, you overgrown lump of mold!
Please, let's not resort to name-calling.
Who made you the boss, you wilted weed?
Flathead!
Shrub!
Entree!
Loaf!
Pabulum!
Grub!
Morsel!
Gobbet!
Tidbit!
Stop!
What's going on in here? I thought I heard shouting, "This means war!"
No, it doesn't. You're all being silly fighting like this. If there's one thing I've learned since I've been here, it's that no food is an island.
What?
What are you talking about?
You two are arguing about whether cheese or bread is better, but it takes cheese and bread to make a cheese sandwich, which is maybe the most perfect food there is. And neither of you could do it without the other.
C'est vrai.
Cheese sandwich.
And there's other stuff too. What about peanut butter and jelly? Or macaroni and cheese? Or peaches and cream? All the best things to eat are made by different kinds of food working together. And that's what you should all be doing. Instead of fighting, you can work together to create new and better things.
New? Better?
Sure, like maybe an apple broccoli bean cheese and lollipop sandwich.
The kid's got a point.
We have been most foolish.
Put her there, partner.
All right, yeah, let's do it.
Cooperation? Why this means I'm
peace, General. Peace.
Exactly. In that case, I hereby officially and irrevocably declare peace. Hooray!
Great speech, Sam. You really saved the day with that one.
I'm glad I could help.
Can you stick around to help us make plans for the future? Or have you got to get home for dinner?
Dinner? Oh my gosh, I forgot.
Pajama Sam. It's a night thing. Call him Pajama Sam.
Hey,
Are you sure you want to leave?